But the tower still stands, Jack.
But for how long?
But for how long indeed?
He's, whoa!
Success.
A very, very methodical play here by Fnatic.
Are the North American casters a little salty that Fnatic are beating TSM so convincingly?
I'm not salty. This is an amazing game.
Absolutely not. You're pulling salt out of thin air right here, Trevor.
Local audience stunned
absolutely.
By that performance.
Our letters may be NA, but we're not made of salt, Trevor.
But also a terrible matchup, because Cassiopeia just crushes Gnar. They definitely practiced that. But also, Santorin's a non-factor. Sejuani's open.
A little bit of mid lane.
Looks like Thakalese and Thaldrin just on the other side, and it's going to be as well. Dumbledoge from the top lane. The hits go in. Oh, 10 points to Dumbledoge. First blood.
But Sheik does kills Faker.
Of SKT. That last outer tier turret goes down, and they now have their eyes only set on the base. He emperored him off the wall. He can't get through the gate. Faker, playmaker.
Dumbledoge. This is 10 points for Dumbledoge.
Yeah, that was the most troll comment ever.
Very easy for HQ to move in, take over the entire map, clean up these objectives, and they can stack dragons as well. Number three here, the speed is going to be quite large.
Elvis is really, really good at death sentences. It can't hit a stationary dragon.
It hadn't spawned yet, I think. I hope that was the reason why Elvis otherwise...
He was predicting the dodge.
Yeah, he's mad lighting the dragon.
Yeah.
Would be willing to first pick Kalista.
I'm going
to
go out on a limb and say it will be banned. Bang is still 6-0 now on Kalista, still undefeated. So yes, I think that one will be banned.
Kalista will be banged.
That's a lot of bans we're already talking about right now, because we have Faker who's undefeated on LeBlanc, Bang who is undefeated on Kalista.
Got caught off guard by Fnatic, but SKT doesn't seem like the kind of team that even has to pull out anything weird, because just systematically they are a much better team than TSM.
Well, they're a very versatile team, right? So, quote-unquote, weird.
Yeah.
They can use so many different champions and strategies.
For the Dragon Pit, looks like he's going to try to get over the wall. Not going to work, though. Oh, Chilling Smite, Santorin in a lot of trouble here. Lust. Oh!
Headbutting him back out of the lantern.
Oh, from Diary turns around immediately onto TSM. Look at that nice headbutt pulverized. Santorin trying to help his teammates escape. Lust Boy pulled over the wall by Wild. Doesn't do a ton of damage.
Very unfair situation also for Wild Turtle. Being as...
Oh, Chilling Smite, Santorin in a lot of trouble here. Lust Boy!
Oh! Meanwhile, Efya Shox Deportia is standing by in the interview area, getting the inside. In the jungle, Clear Love. Pawn in the mid lane, Deft at AD carry, and Mako at support. And Yellowstar on support. Wow, words are escaping me today.
Should expect it. Should get caught off guard. Yellowstar getting there a little late to stop it. He flashes for it, though.
Yellowstar.
And it's working out for Reyna.
There's a game to build Warrior Enchanted.
Oh, it's another one.
Get out of that wall, buddy.
He can still live. Here comes Tony. He's on to Mako. Rainover's going to stay alive.
Goodness,
rack up a few extra kills. I think the timing.
Walk this way.
Get back here, man.
Thank you, gentlemen. Ed Crumbs, talk to me, man. How you feeling after that game?
I mean, that was over a kill a minute for EDG alone. I mean, come on, that was nasty. That should have been censored.
Love me like you do. Love me like you do.
You know that this will go on Reddit, right?
No, sorry. It's not record.
Who may actually flash this on beautiful Arcane Smash.
Oh!
All the way down! And another one!
Oh!
If we lose this one, no chance. Make sure we give it our all for this.
Yeah. No chance, guys, if we lose this one.
Yep.
No chance whatsoever.
Hashtag the lost chance.
Now as AHQ take down Team Solo Mid, 29 minutes on the clock.
What a dominating performance here from AHQ.
Managed to back. He's been putting on a lot of pressure here.
Oro looking for it in the top lane. Thaldrin's gonna flash into the wall.
hope you can surprise SK Telecom.
Hope you can surprise must be what they are banking on here. We will see now as we head up to the caster's booth for a look at the teams. We'll hear on how the spread of the Korean talent around the world is.
He's going to run his mana down to half before this potentially apocalyptic fight here at Dragon.
Apocalyptic, wow.
I was trying to think of a big word. I think I reached a little too far.
Ragnarok-esque fight.
That's right. Brilliant fight right there from SKT. It was Fnatic pulling the trigger to try and get out. Fnatic can push through the tank line to get to Bang, and whether they get the burst...
Oh, Hai ran over.
Whoa!
The wall, he comes with the... Hey, what's Kalista's favorite restaurant? IHOP.
Oh, God.
Sorry. I'm so sorry. I haven't been booed by thousands.
But that's what both teams have going for them.
Well, they had different kind of heartbreaking loss, because if you got to remember that in caveating my point...
You could say, welcome to Summoner's Rift, guys. Here we go. Fnatic versus Beşiktaş. It is time. Yeah! Right?
To scream into the camera.
That's right. That's right. He's getting so low, the Rend may just do it. Oh, he picks up the heal. Meanwhile, action up there. Siakli's getting low. Double Doge manages to stay alive for now. Can he do it? Oh, the spear coming out of nowhere. He was sniped. Snipe killed Double Doge.
Oh, God.
Oh, no.
Spoiler alert,
Noah.
Wait
so long.
Sorry. Spoiler alert.
100 gold ahead is...
Not sure it's time to slow down. That was easy.
Right, and on the hunt, looking for Marin. Albus does have the ability to throw the mine down. Dredge line out in a second. What? Keeps Marin in place.
Even the best players in the world will flash into the wall.
What's out? Are we not going to get a chance to revisit it?
Oh, come on!
Is visiting Hooney. You talked about SKT playing around Hooney, and now they are doing it. Equalizer is down. It's Korean on Korean battle, and it's Hooney that wins! Hooney takes down Faker in a 2v1!
Except Vivin's still here. They should know that he's down there. They need to back off.
Everybody saw that. Onto Wolf and Bang in the back line, running them out of the fight as well. Come
by
down.
The skin
not even
of
close.
His teeth. It's Korean on Korean battle, and it's Hooney that wins. Hooney takes down Faker.
It's just a little pet peeve I have because people use it so much. Immobility is an absolute term. There are not varying degrees of immobility. If you're going to call him, you know, a low mobility champion, she can still slither around.
All right, touche. The low mobility champion.
I like it.
And here's a listen in of Bebevin calling it in Picks and Bans.
By the way, I'm gonna solo kill this guy, okay? Like, if you ward for me, I can play aggressive as f***. I can just jump on him 24/7 and then he's dead.
Same.
The visits into the jungle not as fruitful.
And there's the death mark coming in.
And will it be enough? The pop and the ignites! Aggressive pick-making team. Faker eats two shurikens. The knockup is interrupted as Febivin materializes. Ignites, oh. Plus one more! That is two 1v1s in a game!
Yes, he is.
Popping off. Is that an American saying?
I don't know what the kids are saying these days.
The MR is concerned. That keeps him alive. Yellow Star and Hooney. That's a platinum. Yellow Star, but Yellow Star misses the solar flare. Marin goes backwards and the tower gets the kill. What? Fnatic are just everywhere.
Chances to make mistakes. You only get a couple here from Fnatic. And that dragon fight was a pretty big one. Are you okay, Steelback? Hello?
Interesting. HQ is so good at abusing summoner spell cooldowns.
But honestly, both teams here getting comps that really fit their style.
Yeah.
EDG, whenever I watch them team fight, they're so good at getting to the back line. When you have a Kassadin who's going to build the Thieves, they're going to go crazy at that back line. They can get onto the AD carry, onto the mid lane behind to the same strategy from EDG in the lane swaps.
Yeah, you got punished as you see there.
No, please. You couldn't hold back, could you?
Yes. Have you heard about the bird? Bird.
Bird.
Bird. We need a team bird show match sometime. No kidding.
I continuously become disappointed in Kobe.
Yes!
Nice!
That is what we're talking about, energy.
That's right.
Easy three buff.
The Tumble. Not going to take him down.
Tumble. He's low. Is he going to make it? Oh, he gets Xiao Xiao on the way out. I've heard about getting your freak on, but they got on freak.
Oh, this is PG-13, though.
That was beautiful.
Yep. See, the thing is the Noxia has one talent, but Demacia has a three-talent strike. So they can handle triple the Febivin right now.
You've really done your prep work for this. I'm happy
about
it.
That was beautiful.
I had no idea.
He's got no flash, so he can't do the flash sweeping blade.
Let's watch that replay again. Look at this.
Oh, stealth immediately. Freak then burns the heal, condemns him into the scrying orb, mind you.
Freak, what was that?
Beautiful.
Rakes there, so. Not enough damage. And there it is.
Boop.
The Hydra.
That's boop. Right.
Boop. Boop.
A Talon Q. Boop. That is the most painful boop in League of Legends.
Pretty much.
Oh, that
learning
was a
the fury
boop
of the boop.
Too.
Oh, man. Bummer.
So, if the Soul Stealer obviously collects souls, what does the Sword of the Occult collect?
Occults.
Obviously. It seems very obvious now, apparently.
Come on, man. He had just been in front of us the whole time.
Sting the games instead.
Yeah. Credit where credit is due. I think that was the most top lane pressure I've seen TSM apply all tournament.
Oh, God.
What did you think of Freak's Vayne? Because he was giving you guys a hard time.
Sorry.
What did you think of Freak playing Vayne?
Freak?
Yeah. He was in this game. Did you notice?
Yeah. Sorry. AD Swain?
Yeah, that's fine too.
Yeah, it's true. Oh.
How was it? How was it?
It was, sorry.
That's
okay. It was pretty bad. But
Turtle, I gotta say, we set this up specifically so you could have a victory moment, and then it became so close. So I was a little scared. No, seriously, what was it like playing versus the people that usually talk about your plays, good plays and bad plays? That was my bad. Go ahead, Huni.
Sorry? I'm sorry. I'm so nervous now. I don't know.
Can you dance now?
No, I'm so heavy.
Oh, dude.
So heavy?
My belly is so big. So.
Oh, why?
Oh, my God.
Maybe I can dance like Gragas.
Wolf should be able to get there in time. Very nicely done. Crowd control a bit stacked there, giving Koro time to move right away. But Wolf has the rest to finish this off. The wallop keeps him in place. Nobody else is roaming up here. And EDG's not able
still
to
alive.
Get anything. Koro running out, dodges the boomerang back and gets himself a kill.
Of who EDG was going to be targeting in the ban phase. The Azir ban and the Cassiopeia first pick, pushing EasyHunan to something else and making SKT change their strategy a little bit. And SKT was playing catch up the entire.
He's gonna get the binding! He's gonna gnar! That may be enough time, but.
A huge moment for our. Every time EDG, like I picked SKT for this series, but every time EDG locked in a champion select, I was like, shit, their champions look really good. I was like, oh god, that particular has like eyes of a killer. That guy just blankly stares at you like, and he's really good at it as well. I really like it.
Nice role play there.
Thank you.